Good morning, students. Today we are going to learn about integers. Before that, if you are a new visitor for my channel, kindly subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that whatever videos I am uploading related to studies, it will reach. Now we are going to look at the what is natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers all together. Natural numbers is denoted as n. Very simple. Counting numbers are known as a natural number. We can suppose, and if I am asking how many chalk pieces are here, we can count 1 and 2. So counting numbers are known as a natural numbers. Counting numbers are known as natural numbers. Natural numbers can be denoted as capital N. Okay. This is 1, 2, 3, 4. Numbers are countless. That is infinite. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is said to be as a natural numbers. Now, natural numbers with zero are known as whole numbers. See, counting numbers, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. 2, 3, 4, etc. Now, we are adding zero with it. This is known as whole numbers. And whole number is denoted as capital W. Capital W. Whole number is denoted as capital W. Natural numbers, whole numbers, natural numbers, whole numbers with negative numbers. Negative 1, negative 2, negative 3. It is infinite this side, and positive numbers also infinite, negative numbers also infinite. All together, that is known as integers. Integers can be represented as capital Z. Five steps to the right of positive 1. Positive 1 is here. So we are going to move 5 steps to the right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th step. The answer is positive 6. Shall we go to the next example? Next example, 4 steps to the left of minus 1. Where is minus 1? That is negative 1 is here. So we should move to the left side, not right side. This is left side. So we will start from here. Then 1, 2, 3, 4. So the answer is for negative 5. The answer is equal to negative 5. Understood? 4 steps to the left of minus 1. So start from minus 1, then you move ahead 4 steps to the left, then you are getting answer as minus 5. That is said to be as a negative 5. Next example, 7 steps to the left of minus 1. Minus 1 is here and you are going to move to the left side. So again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 and 7, it will reach at minus 8. If you put arrow mark there, it will reach at minus 8. Now, 7 steps to the right of minus 1. See, minus 1 is here, that is negative 1. We are going to move the 7 steps to the right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So we are getting positive 6. As answer. 7 steps to the right of minus 1. So minus 1 and you are moving the 7 step. We are getting positive 6. six steps to the left of positive 3. Positive 3 is here. Again, we are moving six steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. The answer is equal to negative 3. The answer is equal to negative 3. Now, every time drawing number line, is it? It is not possible. Suppose small numbers are given, you can draw the number line. What to do? Suppose big numbers are given. Suppose 63, 100 and 120. Easily we can calculate. See that? Suppose 5 steps to the right, 15 steps to the right of positive 3. Positive 3. 15 steps, you would not move 15 steps. It's a very simple and easy way to find out the right of positive 3. So, plus positive 3 has to be written there. Right side, you add positive sign. If it is left side, you add negative sign. If it is right side, you add positive sign. So, positive 15 steps. So, right of positive 3. So, positive 3 has to be written first. Right side, so you write positive. Then 15 steps you write. So positive and positive, both the numbers are positive. Positive and positive become positive. You add and put positive sign. Add and put positive sign. Another example, just we are going to look at the same we can keep, the same number we can keep. Instead of right, we will write left. Instead of right, we write left. Okay. Then positive 3. Then left side, already I said, if it is right side, put positive sign. A positive sign. If it is left side, you put negative sign. So, positive 3, negative 15. Now, look at the both. You studied that. You saw the video of how to add and subtract the numbers. Both the numbers are in different side. One is positive, another one is negative. See, both the numbers are in different side. What to do? You have to subtract the small number from big number. 3 is small here and 15 is big. So, 15 minus 3, how much will get? 12. And bigger number possesses here, it is considered, bigger number is considered as negative 15. So, bigger number possesses the which sign? That sign has to be there. Bigger number possesses which sign? Negative sign. So, the answer is equal to negative 12. See that both the numbers are in different sign. First you subtract the small number from big number. So 15 minus 3 you are getting 12. See that bigger number possesses which sign? Bigger number possesses negative sign. That sign has to be there. Now we are going to look at one more example. You know, if it is right, you have to put positive sign. If it is left, you have to put the negative sign. See, suppose positive 35, negative 6. Positive 35, negative 6. Can you write the statement for this one? That is, plus 35 minus 6 means 6 steps to the left of positive 35. This is the meaning for this. So, both the numbers are having different sign. What we have to do? We have to subtract. And 35 minus 6, we are getting 29. Okay, subtract and write 29. Now, bigger number possesses which sign? Positive sign. That sign has to be there. Bigger number possesses positive sign. That sign has to be there. So now no need to look at this one. Just two numbers are having difference. Two numbers are having same sign. Add and put the same sign. Even minus 3, minus 6. Both the numbers are having same sign. Add and put the same sign. If both the numbers are having different sign, subtract the small number from big number. And big number possesses which sign? That sign has to be there. See here, 35 plus 35 minus 6. Then minus 8 plus 2. See that minus 8 plus 2, 8 minus 2, 6. And bigger number possesses negative sign. This is the thing you have to learn. See that
Both the numbers are having even positive sign or negative sign. Add and put the same sign. Plus 3, plus 6 is equal to plus 9. Minus 3, you no need to subtract here. Minus 3, minus 6 is equal to negative 9. Negative 3, negative 6 is equal to add and put the subtraction. Add and put the positive sign. Both the numbers are having different sign. Subtract small number from big number. And big number possesses which sign? That sign has to be there. 35 minus 6, 29. And plus 2 minus 8. And plus 2 minus 8, both the numbers have a different sign. So subtract 8 minus 2, 6. And bigger number is 8 here. So minus sign has to be there. Now, one more example. You will get 0 in this example. I forgot to say, 6 steps to the left of positive 6. So positive 6 is here. So if you are reaching 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you will get 0. You get 0. See how you are getting 0. Suppose plus 6. Then left. So you are writing minus 6. And plus 6 minus 6. 6. Both the numbers are in different sign. What to do? You have to subtract. One is positive sign. Another one is negative sign. Obviously you have to subtract. Then 6 minus 6 how much? 0. But listen, 0 does not possess any sign. So you put 0 as it. 0 does not have positive or negative sign. In the case of if you are getting 0, put 0 as it is. Okay, understood. Thank you. Have a great day.